We often create 3D models in 3D CAD systems in such a way that we first create a 2D sketch and then, based on this sketch, create a solid using the 3D solid creation operation. A 2D sketch is the geometries that make up a certain shape, and these geometries should be related to each other in a certain way. We can add relations between geometries using constraints. You can treat this video as a presentation, you don't have to follow the steps. Okay, start FreeCAD and select Part Design Workbench and create a new file and create new sketch on XY plane. First, I will create two lines and a rectangle. Okay. And right-click to cancel this command. And at this point, these geometries are placed freely in the workspace. I can freely change the position and dimension of these geometries. And a sketch whose dimensions and position can be freely changed is not very useful for creating a 3D model. But in 3D CAD systems, you can usually give proper relations to the geometry. And such relationships can be added using constraints. Notice that the rectangle already has several constraints. Constraints are shown with these little red symbols. And this constraint means that this line is horizontal, and this constraint means that this line is vertical. Moreover, these constraints are also in the lists of constraints, and when I click on constraint in the list, it will be highlighted in the sketch. Here, as you can see, in addition to the constraints that determine whether the lines are vertical or horizontal, there are four other constraints, and these are coincident constraints, and they mean that two points are connected to each other. I will select the first constraint in the list, and it means that the endpoint of this line and endpoint of this line are connected. Now if I delete this constraint, select and press delete, now nothing has changed in the drawing, but if I grab this line and change its position, you can see what happened. These two points are no longer connected. Now, if I remove, for example, the constraint that this line is horizontal, select this symbol and press delete, then I can freely change the position of this line. Now, if you want this line to be horizontal again and not slanted, select Constraint horizontally and select this line. The selected constraint is still active, and you can pick more geometries or you can right-click to end the command. And now that line is horizontal again. And if you want these two points to be connected again, select Constraint coincident and select this point and this point. Okay, right click, and now these two points are connected to each other. Similar to the constraint that specify that a line is horizontal, works the constraint that specifies that a line is vertical. Let's draw another line. And when it comes to adding constraints, I can first select the geometry to which I want to add a constraint, and then select the constraint I want to use. And here I will use constraint vertically to make this line vertical. Select the line and select constraint. In the sketcher, we can also delete geometry. If some geometry is not needed, just select it and press delete to delete it. Okay, and now I'm going to determine the dimensions of the rectangle. And dimensions are also a kind of constraint, and to specify the horizontal dimension of the rectangle, select constraint horizontal distance and select the line to be dimensioned and enter here, for example, 100 millimeters. Okay. And when it comes to dimensioning, we can dimension geometries such as lines or circles, but we can also dimension distance between two points. And I'm going to add a vertical dimension to the rectangle, but the command constraint horizontal distance is still active, so right click to cancel this command and select this point and select constraint horizontal distance and enter here, for example, 70 millimeters and OK. The rectangle is dimensioned and I can no longer freely resize the rectangle, and to change a dimension I just have to edit it. And to do that, double click the leftmost button on the dimension and enter a new value and OK. And while I can't freely change the dimension of the rectangle, I can freely change its position in the workspace. And to specify that the rectangle cannot be moved freely, you must constrain the rectangle to another geometry or to coordinate system. The other geometries aren't related yet either, so I'm going to constrain this rectangle to coordinate system. I'm going to make the rectangle symmetrical about the x-axis and symmetrical about the y-axis. So select this point and select x-axis and select constrain symmetrical. And now the rectangle is placed symmetrically about the x-axis. Okay, and let's do the same for the y-axis. Select this point and y-axis and constrain symmetrical. And as you can see, the geometry has changed color, and we will come back to that in a moment, but I will show you another way to place a rectangle symmetrically about the x-axis and about the y-axis. I'm going to undo these symmetry constraints, undo, okay. And symmetry constraints can be added about the axis of symmetry or about a point. Now select this point and this point and select constrain symmetrical, and the rectangle is placed symmetrically about both the x-axis and the y-axis. And when it comes to the symmetry constraint, we can add this constraint relative to a line or relative to a point. And the order in which you select the geometry is important. The last selected geometry is the line of symmetry or point of symmetry. And okay, the rectangle changed color, and this greenish color means that the geometry is fully constrained. Such geometry cannot be changed freely. We can't move it, we can't change its shape, we can't change its position. And when creating 2D sketches in 3DCAD systems, let's try to make the geometries fully constrained. Okay, let's move on to the next constraints. I will show you the next constraints on these lines. Suppose I want both lines to be equal, and to do that, select constraint equal and select this line and this line. Okay, right click to cancel this command, and now both lines are equal. And if I change the length of one line, the length of other line will change as well. Now, for example, I'd like these lines to be parallel. Select these two lines and select constrain parallel. And now lines are equal and parallel. I will remove the constraint parallel. This is the last constraint in the list of constraints. Select and delete. And now, for example, I want these lines to be perpendicular. So select two lines and select constraint perpendicular. And it may seem like these lines have been removed, but here they are. Just grab and drag the align point. Okay. Now these lines are perpendicular, and as you change the position of one line, the position of other line will adjust to maintain the perpendicular constraint. Okay, I will remove this constraint. Okay, and now I will change the position of these lines. Okay, for example, like this. And now select these two points and select constraint coincident. And now I'm going to show you how to determine the angle between these lines. Select two lines and select constraint angle and enter an angle value, for example 45 degrees, and OK. I'm going to move on to more constraints in a moment, but for now select this point and select constraint coincident, and select this point and select constraint coincident. I haven't dimensioned the line length here, but the geometry is fully constrained. These constraints fully determine the shape, dimensions and position of this geometry. Suppose now I want to dimension this line, and to dimension the slanted line you can use constraint distance. Select this line and select constraint distance. And as you can see, the geometry changed its color and warning appeared. This means that if I add this dimension, there will be too many constraints and I cannot add this dimension as driving dimension, but I can add this dimension as reference dimension so that I know what the length of this line is. Okay, we have a few more constraints to discuss. I will draw a circle. And to dimension the circle, select constraint diameter and select circle and enter the circle diameter, for example 50 millimeters. Okay. Right click to cancel this command, and now let's draw line. Okay, right click to cancel this command, and to make the line tangent to the circle, select constraint tangent. Select line, select circle, and right click to cancel this command, and now the line is tangent to the circle. Okay, I will remove this constraint, and we can also use a tangency constraint for a point and a circle. Select this point, select the circle, and select constraint tangent. And now the line is tangent to the circle at this point. Okay, draw a second line. Right click to cancel this command and select this point and select constraint coincident and select this point and circle and select constraint tangent. Okay, and let's add the dimension of the angle between these lines. Okay, 45, and use the constraint coincident to place the center of this circle at the origin. Okay, right click to cancel this command, and now select this point, select y-axis and select constraint point onto object to place this point on the y-axis. Okay, we have a fully constrained sketch, but this sketch is wrong and we can't create a 3D model from this sketch. In FreeCAD, sketch lines cannot intersect. And select this line and select toggle construction geometry to turn this line into a construction line and make it only auxiliary geometry. Now we still need to remove this part of the circle so that this geometry is one single geometry with no intersecting geometries. And to do this, select trim edge and select this part of the circle. Okay, right click to cancel this command and the sketch is finished. And as you can see, sketch constraints are essential to create a precise sketch and are fundamental when it comes to creating 2D geometry. Now this geometry cannot be freely changed, and to make any changes we have to do it by editing constraints. So there is less chance of accidentally messing up the geometry. Okay, click close to exit the sketch, and now we can use this sketch to create 3D solid. Let's select path command and enter, for example, 10 millimeters as length. Okay, I hope this lesson was helpful. Thanks for watching and please subscribe to this channel.